Good morning to everybody. In today's video, I will show you how to activate the PALO-ALTO built-in protection profiles. This will help us to protect our user and server from malicious attacks. So in this video, you will learn how to apply PALO-ALTO built-in security protection profile, how to create and apply zone protection profile, how to create and activate denial of service protection profile. I'm still using the EVNG, so now I power on the Palo Alto firewall one. I turn up the second one because to save some memory. Also, the PC is connected on management VLAN connected to Palo Alto. So when I double click this, I already log in the GUI of the Palo Alto. First, I will discuss to you where to locate the protection profile. So go to the object. As you can see, on the bottom part, there's a security profile. So in this one, you will see they have some default antivirus vulnerability protection. There are some default values, okay, and actions, okay. So this one you can tweak or just read about it, okay. But for the meantime, I just show you where you're gonna find it and then how to apply. So now, since you find the security profile, how we will apply to our policies so that we can protect the users. Okay, we'll go to policies and then we'll go to the security. Okay, from here we will apply from its inside to outside traffic. I will apply this protection profile. So just go to actions and here click profiles, and then you will enable here the default antivirus. Okay, default, you can select either the strict or the default settings. You just read it and study how your threshold you will set, but for the meantime we will use the default created by the Palo Alto. Okay, also this default. Okay, and then press OK. As you can see, now the profile is populated with the protection. Anything traffic from inside to outside, it will be checked by this protection profile. So that's how you apply the security profile. The next security is the zone security profile. So we'll go to the network. We will create one zone security profile. Click this one, and then this is the security, a zone protection profile. Click add, and then for example, we will create that zone protect inside. For example, like that, and then we'll just click the SIN attack, ICMP, other UDP attack. So all of them has default value. You can tweak this one, it's up to you how you will train the firewall to react on the attacks. But for the meantime, we will just use the default values. Okay, we will enable the TCP scan. If somebody is from outside, keep on scanning all the ports, so it will be detected as a threat. And also packet alarm, TCP drop. You can check all of this by yourself, okay, but for the meantime we will just go for the default. No need for ICMP version 6. Click OK, and then after that, how we will apply. So we'll just go to zones, and then for example the inside zone. And then here on the zone protection, you just click the zone protection profile, And then as you can see, also the enable packet buffer protection already by default by the Palo Alto, because there's an attack for the buffer packet also, that most common attack. So click OK, and then that's it. Our protection zone protection profile is done. Okay, the next thing is we need to set up the DoS protection profile. Okay, on DoS protection profile, you need to create one. Okay, then we'll name it the DoS protect. For example, we'll just say server SVR. Just you can put any name, okay? And then we will enable the synplood attack, UDP attack, ICMP plood attack, and other IP plood attack. And then it will be aggregate or classified, but for the meantime, we will create only the aggregate. Then press OK. Okay, now how we will apply the denial of service protection, you have to go to policy, and then here DoS protection, okay, and then create a new one, okay, and then we'll tell protect server, and then source will be from from outside, okay, going to destination will be zone. We'll just add from outside to inside, okay, and then option protection, we'll see here protect, and then from here aggregate, we need to select the profile that we created, and then click OK. Click this service, and then click OK. So now we apply everything, the three built-in protection for the Palo Alto. After that, you just click commit, and everything will be activated. So we'll review on the network. We assign the zone protection profile on the policies. We assign on the security, we assign on the inside to outside traffic policy, and also on the DoS protection, we assign protect my server, okay, and also on the zone, which is on network, and then zone, we also have applied this zone protection profile. So that's it, and thank you so much for watching, and then please watch my next video, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much.